Hello everyone and welcome to this Friday session video. This is Jordan from the Traders Terminal and today we're going to talk about dollar franc. I believe we have here some interesting midterm opportunity which is not yet triggered, but we're right on the level. So let's go ahead and cover it. Okay, so starting from the daily chart. Of course, we're starting with the levels, and the very first thing which is probably clear and obvious for everyone is that we are very close to a trend line. This is somehow turning into a good double trend line principle video. However, the trend line that we need to break is kind of far away in this case. The slope is very steep. This is why I prefer to handle this situation in a slightly different way. So first level trend line, then we have a horizontal level right here. Okay, we can clearly see that. If I go ahead and click on the indicator, we can see that there is plenty of volume around this zone and we're currently testing the bottom of this magnificent level right there. So everything starts to fit together. And we kind of understand that this is a critical level for the price, which means we're likely going to get at least some kind of pullback. I'm not talking about complete reversal going here, catching this kind of move, right? I'm talking about intraday, mid to short term opportunity, catch a few pips, and then we're good to go. So that's pretty much what we have about the daily chart. Next, I like to do multi-time frame analysis, which means I'm dropping to the 4-hour chart. And here, as we can see, there is some sort of structure that is being completed, which for me doesn't really matter because at the moment there is no divergence on the MAs. And I'm more or less looking at this thing as a range, right? I'm not looking at it as an impulsive structure. Maybe on the inside of this range, we have impulse, but not on the 4-hour chart, okay? I don't see it this way. So the 4-hour chart doesn't really tell me much because I'm not using the cycles, I'm not using the divergences here, but if I drop to the 1-hour chart, now things start to become much more interesting. Once again, here are the levels. And once again, we can see the price is consolidating in a smaller scale. We do have one leg divergence already. However, this is not really what I'm looking for. I'm looking for something like this. So you have negative histogram, positive histogram, negative histogram. I would like to see clear waves being developed, right? And MACD often is helping you to identify these situations. So what I'm expecting from the price is to create further push lower. And if you think about it, you already have first false break right here. So on the lower timeframes, that is probably already giving us, no, it's not. Even on 30-minute chart, it's still one leg. You see no negative histogram here, which more or less is confirming what I believe is going to happen. I believe we're going to get another push lower. I believe we're going to get here a red histogram. I believe this is going to do something like that. And if it does, this is where the actual opportunity starts to present itself. Now, since this is a bearish trend, when we look at it from 1 hour, 4 hour, maybe even from daily perspective, the price is moving lower, okay? From here on, it's been moving lower. This is a bearish trend. So basically what we're trying to do here, regardless of the higher timeframes, is to catch a reversal, right? We're not trading a pullback inside a trend, right? We're not trading here to sell. We're actually trying to get a pullback. If this is what you're doing, then probably you should consider being a bit more conservative, letting the price first of all reverse, and then you catch it. So this is actually what I'm going to do. However, I'm going to also show you, if you want to be going aggressive here, attacking the level, how you can catch that very easily. Now, if you want to do the divergence trade here, let's say you're doing divergences and you want to be trading the divergence trade, What you will be looking for is, let's focus on this part for a second, just to give you an example so you can see where I'm going with this. What you can be looking for is either for the histogram to tick up, which happens on this bar right here. So you have lower, 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 and then boom, it ticks up. It basically creates a button here, right? This is what a tick up means. Or you have an alternative, which is to wait for the MAs to cross and do this kind of button, right? Either this one or that one. So using a third-party software, in this case, the software is Spotlight Trader Infinity. What we can do, why is this? Okay. What we can do is use the indicator sequence. So simply click on that, and you can select a red histogram to bottom. So if a histogram creates a bottom, you set up market buy or pending order, whatever it is you're going to do. In our case, market buy with the risk type, et cetera, et cetera. And once this happens, which means divergence is completed, boom, you're in a trade. Then you can use the stop loss, which is last five bars. So imagine this is the situation, right? This is where the bar ticks up. The software will count the last five bars, which is up to here somewhere, right? And it will place buy order plus a stop loss right here, which is going to give you the divergence, right? So this is one way to do it. Again, I don't think this is the proper way to do it because we're looking for a reversal and that might kick us out. It is a bit more aggressive. If you want to be doing that a bit more conservative, as I said, waiting for the reversal to happen, you can be waiting for a convergence. And what is convergence? Basically, once you have the first step, which is the divergence, then you want to see the price breaking above the middle point of the divergence. And then you're expecting the price to continue up. So if I'm not going to be around the PC at that very moment, what I can do is, since I'm expecting for this thing to push lower, I can already start looking for this convergence. So here is how I'm going to do it. Let's say that I would like to see the price going and reaching, I don't know, this zone in order to push lower. Let me see what level is that. 1995. So there we have it. Now we even have a round number here. I didn't see that. So let's use the round number, which is 91. Okay, just to be on the safe side. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say I would like to use the two-step entry. And if the price, market price, breaks below 0.91, as we said. So basically, what I'm asking for is for the price to do this. And then if we have a breakout above 91.25, let's say, you can, of course, do it with bar close if you're looking for a close to reconfirm it a bit better, right? Slightly more conservative. Then I would like to do, let's say, market buy order, right? So click on market buy. You have the setup of the two step entry. So price goes lower, price breaks above. Then I want to be buying with the breakout above here. Okay, right there. And if that happens, you can be using the stop loss or you can just create stop loss based on the last five bars. In my case, I would like to use the stop loss because there will be probably more than five bars until the low. So I will just place the stop somewhere around here, right? I know I have the daily zone. And if we create a convergence, I know this is going to be most likely more than enough. So I'm going to protect this level right here. I'm going to select a percentage of my balance, and I'm going to be risking 2% of my balance. And that's it. Now I see the numbers. Now I have the levels. The first target will be approximately here, slightly below the tick zone, right? The thickest zone, which is going to give me a risk reward ratio of 1 to 3, Sorry, no, this is not 1 to 3. We're looking at this thing slightly higher from here to here, right? Because it's a market buy, the line stays with the market price. But even if we look at it from this point, 33 versus 50 something, 53. Good enough. I like it. Now let's take this thing one step further. Okay. We spoke about convergences, which is basically the price is doing that. You get the divergence right here. We get the breakout point. And then after the convergence, you expect the price to push lower, pull back, and you're looking for continuation. Usually with convergence, the optimal place to go ahead and attack is during the pullback. In our case, let me just get rid of this. In our case, I'm also going to remove those. All right. This is where the convergence point is. So the idea is simple. If the price drops lower and then it goes up, we now have a 99% convergence here created. But attacking, as we set it up with a market buy right here during the breakout, is not optimal. Of course, the price could be breaking and flying, right? That happens. And you're going to miss it if you do what I'm about to suggest here. But many times, once the breakout happens, you get a pullback. So let's take it one step further and look for the pullback. This is a decent level over here, which means if there is a breakout and a pullback, the price is likely going to give us a pullback next to this zone. And we're going to try to catch the bottom of this level right here. Okay. So how do we do that? Just changing one small thing of the whole setup. So instead of market buy, I'm going to say buy pending. And then I'm going to set the stop loss at the same place. But this time, what's happening is if the price gets to this zone and then the price breaks above this level, the software is going to place a pending order right here, a buy limit, right? So instead of attacking right there, we are going to wait for a pullback and we're going to hope for a pullback to get to this zone and boom, you get a trigger with your pending order. Okay, so this is how you can even get this, the optimal out of this setup. Okay, just one step further. All right, that would be all. If you have any questions, you know where to find me. Thank you and have a wonderful weekend.